know that we don't do that just like this, but we understand actually why we're checking that. So maybe...
Go on the pilot side.
Yeah.
I go on the co-pilot and you come on the...
Yeah.
On the walkway.
Yeah.
Oh. Hello. Yeah. With the engine, we have some instruments. We have the hairpin. Mm-hmm. You know this?
Yes.
Okay.
I know. The power.
Okay. Instrument with the engine, this is important, the fuel pressure. You have a green area.
Mm-hmm.
When you start, the limitation is in the green area, half until 8. If you are below or up, something is not normal. This is the reason we have an electrical fuel pump here. More. You have to change one time the switch.
Okay.
If you make this alternator of battery on, you select the fuel pump electric. You can hurt now the small pump. This pump electric is installed on the firewall. I will show you after.
Okay.
And if you have too low pressure, when you engage the electric fuel pump, normally the pressure increases.
Right. So when I switch it off, it should stay the same, right?
Exactly.
If it doesn't stay, what do I do?
If first thing, it's normal when the pressure stays like this now, because now the line of the fuel system electric pump is closed. If you switch off and the indication go down, something is wrong. And normally when you have this, you have an oil leak, fuel leak, sorry.
So I cannot. So if I'm in the air, I should actually land soon?
Normally when you have a fuel leak, your engine
is dead.
It's not dead, but can stop.
Right, and so if I'm still on the ground and I see that, then I don't fly and I bring that to you.
You have two fuel pumps, electrical and mechanical. The mechanical work when the engine is running. If you have a problem on this pump, you have the indication go
down
and after you can put on and the fuel pump come again the pressure. If it doesn't come, your engine stops.
Okay, so then if I'm in the air, I really have to land soon.
Why?
Okay, just checking.
But it's very rare this.
I hope so.
I never saw. Okay.
Right.
Okay, this is the fuel quantity on the wing.
Yeah, the that would be linked to this one where I select.
And right.
Perfect.
Now we are on the off position because I'm working on the engine. I show you what I make now. I clean some filter, fuel filter. This is the reason now is off.
Right.
This is the ampere meter. And...
alternator.
Yes.
Right.
Here you have another annunciator light, some indication the vacuum, alternator and oil pressure.
Right.
Now when you start the engine, you put your alternator, you start like this, only with the battery on. This light stay
on
because the alternator is not charging and the ammeter is stay on the zero. And when you put alternator on with engine running, this one switch off, is off, and the ammeter go a bit around the 10 ampere or 20 ampere.
So it's loading.
It's loading, yes.
Okay.
Now another thing interesting. You start your engine. You put some electrical component on, like the pitot. What's happened? The pitot heat under the wing, you know what is the pitot heat?
Yeah.
You have this system, the heating, because when you fly with the cold air, you can have ice
can block.
On this pitot.
Right.
And the pitot is the indication for the speed. This is a reason with some temperature, you look this with your instructor, you have to put pito on. And what's happened, this heating system consume a lot of electrical power. And when you switch on, the amat go up.
Right.
Maybe if you have only the pito, maybe 20 ampere or 25 ampere, because the system pump
it's charging a lot
electrical in the battery.
Okay.
And the alternator work more to charge the battery.
Right.
After you put an under consumer, you have the pito on, you have the anti-collision light on, you have the nav light on, you have the ventilator on. Mm-hmm. Your amet increase for 40, 50 ampere, and at this moment the alternator work a lot. And an advice when you fly. Okay, the fuel is important, and also the electrical system. If during your flight your alternator light come on, mm-hmm. you have a problem with alternator. It's not charging. And the third thing, you switch all electrical component off, because if you leave the pito, the fan, the nav, all electrical. At this moment, the alternator is not charging, and with this consumer, the battery gave the voltage on each consumer. And at the moment you have an alternator light on, you have more or less with a good battery, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Because you check the battery, the main battery, all 100 inspection.
Mm-hmm.
You have 1 hour. After 1 hour, your battery is flat,
it's dead, yeah.
And you have no radio. You lose all electrical system. This is the reason to preserve the battery, because the alternator is not charging. You switch the pito, you switch the anti-light, the nav light, the ventilator light, and your ammeter go a bit down, mm-hmm. because you pump
less. But if I have to switch off the avionics, let's say,
yes.
then if I'm in the air,
alors,
that's a bit
you leave your avionic. You switch all other system,
right.
and you leave your avionic because you're in contact with the tower.
Exactly. Okay.
And first thing, you inform the tower, I have a problem with alternator system. I come back in the airport for urgent. It's urgent.
Mm-hmm. Huh?
And you can leave the avionic, and maybe until you make you go around and you are back, the battery is enough
mm-hmm.
for your radio.
Right.
But maybe if you have consumed all battery reserve, mm-hmm. the avionic
will not work.
And at this moment, you look this with your instructor. You have another procedure to inform the tower, because you have no communication.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's you come 3 times on the top of the tower. I don't know. Look this.
Radio communication loss.
Yes.
Yeah, there are several procedures for every airport actually.
Yes.
You leave the control zone and you land on an uncontrolled field if you lose radio contact.
Okay. Okay. You have to look.
That's
this.
Another item. Yeah.
Let me know also. Because maybe it's changing. I'm not a pilot.
Maybe the low voltage light. You can explain it because we discussed that before.
Okay. Exact. Not all aircraft have this light.
Mm-hmm.
LOV,
mm-hmm.
low voltage. When now you start your engine, okay, you saw before is red. Huh?
Yes.
This is a light, in fact, on va faire ça simple. This light is connected with your battery.
Right.
The battery is the capacity is 14 volt, 1.4, when it's charged.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for some reason, during the flight, you lost your alternator, you lost the power in the battery, And this light at, I think is 12 volt or 11 volt. I'm not sure, I will let you know after. This light come on.
Okay.
This is an indication your battery is have a reserve 11 voltage.
Okay.
It's only an indication for your battery capacity.
So when they say press to test, what shall I do? I mean, I press and yes. Then what?
In fact, now is red because your battery is in the minimum, under the minimum capacity.
No.
And when we will start the engine with the alternator charge, it come off.
Okay.
Okay. And when it's off, you can push mm-hmm. to test the bulb, you know, if mm-hmm. it's not burned.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Like this one, huh? This yeah. tree. If I push here, yeah. you can see here now, you check your bulb.
Right. Huh?
Because maybe your bulb is burned. And if it's burned, if you have a problem, you have never indication. When you have right. a problem, you know what I mean, huh?
So you're just checking the signal.
Exactly, right. exactly. This switch, and when you switch this one, you check the signal, the condition on the bulb. Maybe the bulb is burned.
Mm-hmm. Okay, makes sense.
We switch off because yeah, we consume the... oh, yes. Another thing. Here you have a vacuum auxiliary pump. If I push, if now you fly, here you have an indication for the vacuum system.
Right.
As I said last time, on the engine you have a pump, a vacuum pump, hein, for diverse instruments. We will see this after. When this pump is off, is at a problem, you have an emergency electrical pump here. When you push, look now, the indication of the suction hein, mm-hmm. for the vacuum system is on the zero. If I put this one on, I have 5 inch hein, of mercury. This is the same, this is the minimum suction we need for the instrument.
Mm-hmm.
And you use this one when the mechanical pump is broken. At this moment you have the light. Huh?
Okay. Yeah.
And when you switch on, this one go away because the system is working. This is the emergency system. Huh?
Right.
Okay, I switch off for the battery.
Yeah.
It's clear for you?
It is clear. And then we have the oil.
Alors, yes, exact. On continue par là. Okay, when your engine is running, you have oil temperature. Same the fuel system, you have the fuel pressure, you have a green area limitation, a minimum and a maximum. And you have to stay in this green area. If you are over the red, in fact, the cooling system, when the engine is running, the temperature of the engine is increased, the temperature hein, of the cylinder, four cylinder. When you fly, you have the air is coming, like the car,
mm-hmm.
in the engine bay and cooled the system. If, for example, you fly and you have a bird,
mm-hmm.
it's coming in the engine bay. Your flow of air is blocked,
mm-hmm.
and at this moment, sure, your cylinder heat temperature increase. If you are on the green, okay, no problem. But maybe if you have a big bird, you are in the red. And for this reason, again, if you are in the red, you inform the tower, okay, I come back.
Well, because I need to land immediately.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Immediately, yes, as soon as it's possible.
Mm-hmm.
Because at this moment, your engine can go in overheating and you can damage the engine,
mm-hmm.
the cylinder.
Mm-hmm.
This is very rare as well. And oil pressure, this is also important. Oil and fuel are important. An electrical system. When you start, as I said last time, you have the engine, you have a lot of parts with mechanical friction.
Mm-hmm.
and the oil make the cooling of the mechanical friction. And say when you start, when the engine is cold, your needle will stay at because the oil at this moment is cold, you have high pressure, you are more or less at 80 psi, maybe 90 in the yellow area. This is normal. And after when the engine is heating, this oil fluid was thick. Mm-hmm. When it's cold, when it's warm, the fluidity is more, comment on dit?
It's getting more fluid.
More fluid. Mm-hmm. And you will see your needle degrees go back in the green area normally. You have to stay in the green, green area.
So when I start the engine, yes, and then I always need to check that it's rising within 30 seconds. Let's say if it's not rising,
After 30 seconds, you stop the engine. Okay. Because if you have no oil pressure, first thing, you have no lubrication. Mm-hmm. All mechanical parts in friction with no oil, you block the engine. Yeah. And you put a, it's not good for the engine, and the engine can stop.
Right.
Always in the green area. And another thing here, you have the oil.
Mm-hmm.
When you have your contact,
yes,
I have no pressure, this one is on. When you start, the needle go more or less 80, and this one go away.
Right.
If during the fly, like before, this one come on, you look here and you will see normally the needle go on the zero. And as well, it's not good. You try to inform the tower, making mechanical problem, and you come back before the engine starts.
Okay.
Qu'est-ce qu'on peut encore discuter? Okay, here you have diverse instruments. Bon, RPM, you know this is a gyro, you know this.
I will learn a bit later on.
We're not there yet.
You have the altimeter also for the altitude, the vertical speed. Okay, you will see this with Michael, the horizon. Alors, this one, not this one, this one. This one and this one worked with the vacuum system. If now you lose the vacuum, you lost this instrument, and you have this switch. Huh?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
This is the airspeed and the turn and back, the turn and back indicator. You discuss with this with Michael.
Right. One question I would have then on the RPM, etc. So when you are doing the run-up, then you always have to check the functions, so magnetos and these sort of things.
Mm-hmm.
When we check the mixture functions, we need to check that the EGT is rising, and sometimes it's getting very slow, so I never know what to do.
Okay, for the EGT, okay, you are in fly, you have more or less a power, your mixture is rich. Huh? When this is the maximum fuel for your engine. Now, depend your fly, you can make economy with the fuel. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
For this, you can lean. Huh? One important thing is on the limitation, on the IFM, you have a maximum exhaust gas temperature, maximum limit.
Mm-hmm.
On these indicator, the first is 1,200 degrees, 1,300, 400, 500, 600
right.
degrees of Fahrenheit, and the maximum, if you look in your IFM. And this engine is around 1,500 or 600. Now, this is, for example, the maximum if you look. Okay, on va le mettre à 1,500. If now you lose, you lean. When you lean, you diminue. the fuel.
You reduce.
You reduce the fuel in the engine.
Right.
And what's happened, in fact, you have the air and the fuel. You lean a bit and always you look the indication. And at this moment, when you lean, you will see the needle go up 1,200, 300. You can go until the max, but not more.
Okay.
Because normally you go on the max, and when you are on the max, you reach a bit more to reduce under the maximum area.
Right.
And you have found the best consumption.
Mm-hmm.
Consumption,
yeah.
But never go over the maximum, because what's happened in the cylinder, you have not enough fuel, and we can discuss after, you have the exhaust valve. This valve is it's a door.
Mm-hmm.
When the air and fuel is burned, this door open and the piston put away this air, this mm-hmm. exhaust.
Mm-hmm.
But if the mix is too lean, when you have not enough fuel, the exhaust valve, the door, elle rougit. Elle chauffe,
can burn.
You have a deformation.
Right. Okay.
Alors, if you burn this exhaust valve after you have a deformation, and when you stop your aircraft, you lost the compression in the cylinder.
Mm-hmm.
I will explain you this after front of the engine. You remember the fuel system?
Yes.
Fuel tank?
Yeah.
Fuel selector in the cabin. This is the fuel bowl, this is a filter. Here you can drain.
Yes, which I do.
Okay. After going the electrical fuel pump,
mm-hmm.
and after inlet, outlet, and after going the mechanical fuel pump.
Yeah.
This one works when the engine is running.
Mm-hmm.
Inlet, outlet, via the carburetor. And here you have the air plus the fuel.
Yes.
Go in each cylinder. 1, 2, 3, 4. What else?
Ah. Well, so this EGT then?
EGT is here, look, other side. This is the inlet tube. This one comes from the carburetor with the air and fuel.
Mm-hmm.
Go in the cylinder. Here you have two valves, the manifold, intake valve,
mm-hmm.
and exhaust valve. Closed, open here.
Mm-hmm.
Air is coming in, burn, and after off, out via the exhaust valve. And after go here and go out from the exhaust. And here you have a small probe to measure the exhaust gas temperature,
mm-hmm.
the outlet
mm-hmm.
after the combustion.
And that's what it shows in the cockpit.
Exactly.
Okay.
Alors some aircraft have, because you have four cylinders,
mm-hmm.
our aircraft have only one EGT. But some aircraft have for four cylinders, four EGT.
Okay.
Or six cylinders, six EGT.
Okay.
Like the Cessna is in the hangar here with six cylinders. This engine have six EGT, and the pilot can see the exhaust gas temperature for each cylinder.
Oh wow, okay.
C'est intéressant.
Mm-hmm.
You can see, oh, one cylinder is too hot, too...
So it's more precise.
Yeah, very, c'est vraiment précis.
Okay.
This is the alternator.
Mm-hmm.
You make the charge for the battery, the main battery.
So that's why you need to take attention, to pay attention to the belt.
The belt,
right?
Yes. When the engine is running, the crankshaft is turning with the propeller,
yeah.
And we via the belt, you have the alternator.
So what happens if something happens in the air? Like, can you lose the belt?
It can happen. Huh? If your bird is coming inside, maybe
yeah.
the bird
so
coming
cuts
here.
The belt.
Maybe if this alternator, this shaft is not turning, you lost the charge.
Right. Okay.
This is a oil radiator. Maybe we spoke last
time. No, we didn't.
Okay. When the cowling is in place,
mm-hmm.
you have a hole here, and here. The air is coming in this bay. This one is closed. And the air cools the cylinder
mm-hmm.
through the cylinder here. And the air go also in this hole here via this tube through this radiator. In this radiator, you have an inlet and outlet oil. And this air makes the cooling for the oil.
All right, okay. And so that's what you choose on the cockpit as well, in the temperature.
Exact. What else?
But in winter time, this
okay.
is normally closed.
Exact, because in winter, when you have minus 15 outside,
mm-hmm.
if at this moment the mechanician put here a plate
mm-hmm.
to close the flow of the air.
Ah, right, because it
yes.
would be too, just too cold.
Yes,
we
have a temperature. And the outside air temperature made the cooling for the oil, because with minus 15 or 20, it's enough.
Yeah.
And at the spring, when we have the correct temperature
mm-hmm.
increasing, we remove again
the plate. Okay.
If I leave this plate and the spring is coming with the correct temperature, your temperature oil
will be increasing.
Going in the red.
Right.
C'est tout à fait logique. Hein?
Mm-hmm.
Another detail, we spoke last time, this is the vacuum pump.
Yes, we did. Yeah.
Okay. Here, this black component and this one the same, we don't discuss. This is the magneto.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay. Just a small discuss. You have two magneto.
Mm-hmm.
Left
and right.
And right.
Yeah.
On your ignition switch, you have with the key the position off.
Yeah. Right.
Right.
Left.
Both.
Yeah.
Start. Yeah, you know. Parfait. Now, comment dire? One magneto, you have four cylinders. Each cylinder have two spark plugs, one on the top
mm-hmm.
and another one
below.
The cable, all cable on the top come on one magneto.
Mm-hmm. Just one?
The right.
Okay.
And the below, the other magneto.
Okay.
Oh. Alors, au cycle explosion, you have intake, compression, explosion,
mm-hmm.
exhaust. On the cycle explosion, the spark plug receives the spark to burn the air fuel. Alors, when the air, you are on the both position, both magneto gave the spark, one magneto on the top and one on the below. You have the spark.
Mm-hmm.
Ping, ping. When you make, okay, your engine work with two magneto. Your engine can work only with one magneto. Two is for the safety.
Mm-hmm.
Now, before your flight, you make
the
your pre-flight.
Yeah. Oh,
check.
Yeah.
You are on both positions. Alors, you make a test if your magneto is working. When you go, you are the boss, when you go on the left, you remove one magneto. Mm-hmm.
Is this the click you hear when you turn the propeller now?
Exact. Now...
Ignition is off.
Okay, it's off. I saw. Good. I look always. When you turn the propeller, you have a... C'est dur, it's hard, because you have a compression on one cylinder. And at the top position, mm-hmm. a bit before the top, you have an explosion. Your magneto give at your both spark plug the spark. This is the spark. Continue to turn and now look, it's coming. Black. At this point, your piston is on the top, receive top compression, the spark, and with the explosion, the piston go away, back. Mm-hmm. And the next time is coming,
yeah.
What is the cycle? Because you have a compression explosion,
yeah.
The next cycle, the piston go up,
yeah.
The exhaust valve open, yeah. And put away the air burned.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But important is, at this moment, the clack, both receive in the same time the spark. You check your magneto, you go both to left, you remove the left magneto. Just, you can see at this moment, just one spark plug receive and your engine continue to run. But at this moment you have a small drop.
Yeah, in RPM, yeah.
Because one spark plug is missing the spark system. Mm-hmm. Huh? In fact, you remove one magneto to check if the other one is working.
Right, okay.
If at this moment the engine stopped, that means the magneto left that you have checked,
mm-hmm.
have a problem,
yeah, yeah.
And your engine stopped.
Right. But can you fly with just one magneto?
Yes.
Okay.
This is the reason, you have two magneto.
Just in case.
If one is broken, the other one work. One make the spark for one spark plug. For the safety, you have two to aliment, pour alimenter les deux bougies en même temps. J'arrive pas bien à expliquer en anglais.
No, but I get that. So, but the spark plug from the bottom is linked to the right one.
Alors,
or is that just a pipe arters thing?
In fact, this magneto give the spark on the two lower and the two upper.
All there. Right, okay.
Tal motor.
So that's the electric vacuum pump.
Yes, this is the auxiliary vacuum pump. You have an electrical motor connected on the vacuum pump. When you switch on, this electric run and run the vacuum, the auxiliary.
Yeah.
For your instrument, mm-hmm. And you can leave. This is the emergency pump when this one is broken.
Right, and so that's what we saw before. So you push that in the cockpit, and then you would have the attitude indicator, altimeter, the gyro. And the gyro. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay.
Can you do that in English, maybe?
Ah, okay.
If you.
No, the difference. Some engine have more cylinder. This is a 6-cylinder flat, 3 on each side. And about the EGT we spoke before,
yes.
You have the outlet tube for the exhaust, 1, 2, 3,
mm-hmm.
And here you have 3 EGT.
All right.
Each tube,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
And under here, this probe and this probe, this is the CHT, 3 and 3,
okay.
CHT information.
Okay.
Il est beaucoup mieux en fait, mm-hmm. Pour indication.
So that's what we said before, it's more precise because then you get the indication for each of them.
If cylinder have indication.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's quite something.
You have more things, but now the engine is closed on the other side. But next time come and we can speak about the turbocharger.